All right. I'm going to pick a puck out of the bag. It's going to have a name on it. And you guys are going to tell me where you think this player would be a good fit, where you think they could go, et cetera, et cetera.
Okay.
Ready? Ege, you want the first one?
Let's go. Bring it on.
First name is Mike Smith.
Mike Smith. That's an interesting
one. That is
one.
A
right
really interesting one, actually.
Because you have a guy who's a goaltender in his late 30s. I think we're seeing more teams now, though, go have a second goalie. And we just, Gary Lawless. What did Gary,
I was just going to say.
What did Gary just say, right? Having an experienced guy to play more games. Now, the only problem is Vegas is kind of capped out, right? So it's going to be hard for Vegas.
He'll command a lot.
He won't command a lot, but he'll command probably more than Vegas wants to spend.
Agreed.
So, you know, I think anywhere where you have a, you need that backup goaltender to help you out. I mean, Mike Smith could be like maybe a $2 million player right now at this point, somewhere in there, maybe with bonuses because he's over 35. But I think anywhere that needs a good, solid number two that could play 30, 35 games, he'd be a fit.
Yeah, Vegas would probably, and I agree.
Yeah.
They need to give Marc-Andre Fleury a little bit of rest. However, I'm not sure that's going to be doable.
Yeah, it's money.
Up against money. The cap, and they just signed.
Like a great example, just real quick from last year, was Hudobin in Dallas and in Boston with Jaro Halak.
What about, what
those
about the
guys
Columbus
were great
Blue
fits.
Jackets? Would that
could be a spot as a, depending on who else they end up with in front. So we'll see.
All right, next puck.
Get Dano a puck there.
Dano's getting a puck.
All right. Ooh, that's a good one.
Little Joe, Joe Pavelski.
Well, I'm assuming there's no way the San Jose Sharks don't find a way. Another team struggling with...
struggling with cap.
They're right up
apparently
against the
they're far apart right now.
Ceiling, but Joe Pavelski has been Mr. Everything for the San Jose Sharks, and I think he would want to return at all costs. However... He doesn't want to be lowballed, I don't believe.
I don't.
This is his last game.
He's turning 35,
maybe
July 11th.
Term
so.
A little
term
less, but he wants.
Thing.
But he would want a pretty nice salary, rightfully so, when he scored 30.
40, I think he had this
40
year.
Goals,
he was up
30.
There.
I can't even remember now. It's so far about 38, 40 goals.
Yeah, somewhere in that
Joe
range.
Joe Pavelski had a terrific season, but he's been the man there
for
quite some time. So
Captain.
That's going to be interesting. And you give Erik Karlsson all this money. How much money is left in the coffers.
Or, and they've got, and they've got other guys to sign as well. So,
Ege, you said term is the thing there. Why?
Well, because he's, you just mentioned, his birthday is going to be 35 right now. He's going to want, like, you know, when Patrick Marleau went through this, right? He wanted a third year.
Yeah.
Ilya Kovalchuk last year, coming back in the NHL, wanted a third year. And so that's the teams are, which teams are willing to give a third or a fourth year? In the case of Pavelski, who's coming off a really good season. So it'll be interesting to see how it plays out. I kind of get the sense that they'll figure it out in San Jose.
Right.
But when you look at the raw numbers, they're up against it right now. So
and
Doug
again,
Wilson's got some work to do.
You know, I wear my emotion on my sleeve. If they can't work it out, three-year deal, New Jersey Devils.
Devils!
Would look awfully nice.
And
in that
here
jersey.
We are talking about the Devils again.
I'm sorry. It
Shocker.
Won't happen again.
Okay. All right.
I just
You're
respect,
greedy. You're
the
greedy.
Respect I have for Joe Pavelski and what he can bring.
Okay, next puck. I'm going to wrestle around in here a little
All
bit.
All right, let's get it going, Jackie.
Jonas Donskoy.
Oh, another shark.
Shark.
Another shark. I think that he is going to be a cap casualty, so to speak, of the San Jose Sharks. I don't know if they're going to be able to bring him back. He's not going to make a ton of money. He's not coming off an unbelievable season, but he's a big-bodied guy who's played in some big games. We just saw a team that was a heavy team win a Stanley Cup, and I think there's teams that want to add some size to their group. And so I think there'll be a number of teams that will be interested in him because the price will be right.
The price will be right, and he does have size.
You'd like a heavy
guys,
winger on the Devils, maybe like that?
He's been very inconsistent the last few years, but he's shown flashes of big goals we've seen the year before in the playoffs. But he's a big body, a playoff-type player, right? For what you're probably
third or fourth line
a reasonable
type
price.
Player.
Name a number of teams.
He's a guy
like
that could go into a big
to
bag.
Fill out your third or even fourth line on a real good team. I look at a team like Colorado Avalanche. Wouldn't a Donskoy maybe be a nice fit for the bottom six?
I like that you're naming teams. EJ's not naming teams.
You know why? Because
well, there's a lot of them.
The Avalanche,
I'll
saw
go
how
through
good
them.
They were
I mean, if
year.
You want, I'll go through them, but there's about 20 that because he's going to be an affordable
that's fair.
Player.
You can name somebody. I just say
like
Colorado
that.
Because they're a team that's on the cusp.
Next pop.
What do you got?
I've got, this is interesting, Ryan Dzingel.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a good chance he could stay in Columbus with the Blue Jackets. I mean, he played college hockey there at Ohio State, but it always comes down to how much money they want to spend, what's the term.
How much he wants or expects.
Yeah, how much he expects. I mean, I think that Columbus, you know, they're going to be losing some players. They're going to have money to spend. I would think if they had a look at him, they know what he's about. You know, maybe they don't see him as someone that fits there, but he's another guy that I don't think you're going to have to break the bank to get him, and he scored a bunch of goals last year.
Career high 26.
Don't you think you'd put him in the category, a guy that had a real good year, obviously a lot of that with Ottawa.
Could go back to Ottawa.
To Columbus, that maybe he's not going to get the amount that the offensive stats warrant, mm-hmm. because he's kind of a more one-dimensional.
Well, the market is going to be completely wide open. I think he's an affordable player. He did have the 26 goals. So, again, I look at him as a guy that a number of teams will look at. There will be some that look at him on there, like that first day. And if he decides to wait and sort through offers, he might have some teams that miss on some players that they wanted that come to him and say, oh, yeah, now he's our plan B, and he might get a significant
offer. Don't
want to
play musical chairs, though, you know, and find yourself without a seat.
That's true.
So if he gets a decent offer right away, you got to contemplate.
He could go back to Ottawa.
All right, guys, one more.
He's good there.
One more real quick.
All right. You picked out two.
I picked two, and I want Dano to pick a hand.
All right.
Left or right?
Left, because I'm a lefty.
Left. Artemi Panarin.
This is
the other one was Sergei Bobrovsky. What are the odds?
They do everything together.
They do. Package deal.
This is the prized possession of this year's unrestricted
free
agent class. You know, all we hear is he loves Florida. He likes the nice weather. The Florida Panthers are a good up-and-coming team. They're a goaltender and a real good player away from, I think, being a contender. So what other place than the Florida Panthers? At Chicago, obviously, he was such a nice fit there. They might bang on his door, as well as, again, the dark horse, the New York Rangers.
Rangers, yeah. John Davidson, very familiar.
Cannot wait with
Panarin.
To see where the bread man and Sergei Bobrovsky. I mean,
right
I thought
through
you were going to score a goal. I thought you were going to toss me the puck.
Toss in the puck. Boy.